Hey guys, what's going on? Chad here, and I'm bringing you another Maplestory video, and it's time for episode number 9 of my Q&A series. And I am going to have to do this Q&A solo alone again. There's two reasons for that this time. One of them, Tina actually had her wisdom teeth removed, so she can't really talk. And the second reason is because I still have yet to fix the issue where my desktop computer is, for whatever reason, just not letting me do dual commentaries, and I'm still working on it. I'm trying to get it to work, and I promise you guys that Tina will be back on these Q&As sometime, but hopefully next time. But anyway, the footage that you guys are watching is me getting the Exorcist Badge from the Singapore quest line, you know, the ghost ship thing. So if you don't know how to do that, just watch the video and you will see how to do it. And I believe it's a level 150 quest line, so you gotta be level 150. And yeah, also thank you guys, because this Q&A actually had way more questions than last time, although a lot of them were repeats. So what I did was I kinda just went through the comments, and if a question was a repeat, I would just answer it in the comments. And I think I'm gonna start doing that from now on. And, you know, if I somehow missed your question, feel free to leave it in the comments of this video, and I'll try to get your question in the next Q&A. So, I have been talking forever, so let's go ahead and get started. Alright, so the first question is by Mighty Blade EMS, and he asks, what kind of education have you done, or are you doing? I totally completed high school. You know, I got a high school diploma. And I'm currently in college right now. I'm going to a two-year college studying computer technology. And I have about two more semesters, maybe three, because I did drop some classes, so I might have to make those up. But I think, actually, I only have two. So two more semesters, and I'm out, and I'll be getting an associate degree. So yay for that. I hate school. All right, this next question is by Nate Yee. And he asks, what do you want to be when you're an adult? Well, I'm in college for computer technology, so I'm kind of hoping to do something in that field. I don't know, I guess we'll see. This next question is by Jerry something. And he asks, where did you train when you were level 15 to 16? Well, from about level 15 till 30, I trained on the starfish things at Nautilus Harbor. I believe they're to the right of Nautilus. So definitely go there until 30. You can also go to, like, Malady, those witch things in Alinea. Those give pretty good experience too. So the next couple of questions are by Cookies Psycho, and he or she asks, cup noodles or packet noodles? I'm going to have to go with cup noodles. I think I've only had them once, though. I've never had packet noodles, I don't think. Unicorns or ponies? I'm going to have to go unicorn. Cats or dogs? Definitely cats. Noodles or rice? I'm gonna have to go with noodles. Alright, the next question is by DaButterBoy, and he asks, if you had to choose between loving Tina forever only on the internet, or being able to live with Tina and have a 50% chance of breaking up, which would you choose? Well, I feel like every relationship, there's always the risk of, you know, breaking up, so I think I would prefer to actually be with Tina in person, just because we've been doing this long distance thing for 2 years now. I mean, it's getting old, you know, I'm ready to actually meet her, and you know, we'll see where it goes from there, I guess. But yeah. Alright, the next question is by Andrew Chin, and he asks, which worlds do you think should be merged? Honestly, I think the only worlds that should be merged are the way, way less populated servers. Maybe even do something like what Gazed did. Gazed is like five servers in one. Or even, you know, merge like a server like Renegades with like a more populated server like Bera, Broa, maybe even Windia or Bellican. Even though Bellican, I guess, is merged with Nova. But, you know, I would like to see something like that. You know, I wouldn't mind if Broa got merged to a lesser-known population, you know. It would help out everyone involved. Obviously, training would be easier. The FM would be nicer. So, you know, I think only less populated servers should be merged. The next question is also asked by Andrew Chin, and he asks, what Pokemon generation do you like best? I can't really pick. I actually like Pokemon from different generations. I don't have like a set favorite generation. Like currently my favorite Pokemon is Scrafty, and that's from 5th generation. So I don't know. I just kind of like Pokemon from different generations, I guess. I don't really have a set favorite. The Mode Step asks, will you start live streaming more and training more? I have actually started training more. Obviously, you guys can see that I'm now level 200. As far as live streaming, you know, I really enjoy live streaming, but I don't think I'm good at it. But, yeah, I mean, if the mood arises, then, you know, I'll definitely live stream. I enjoy it, you know, getting to talk with you guys live. It's really fun, so yeah, definitely. Alright, the next question is by Cody Lee, and he asks, how was life when you were single before you met Tina? And what do you think about people rushing into relationships too quickly? And what should they do to stop that tendency? Before I met Tina, when I was single, I pretty much was the same me. I mean, I wasn't talking to any girls at the time. You know, I spent all my time, you know, playing video games, talking to friends, making my Maplestory character stronger. The same as I do now. Except I'm not single anymore. And I really don't feel like I'm qualified to answer about the rushing into relationships thing, because Tina and I kind of rushed into a relationship. We only knew each other for like a few days, and then we got into a relationship. But, you know, I guess in a way it worked out for us. So I know that rushing into relationships can be very destructive. You know, if you throw everything at the person all at once, you know, they could get freaked out and they could leave. So I guess my only advice is just take it very slow. You know, enjoy the dating period. You know, just get to know the person, let them get to know you, and you guys will decide if you like each other enough or not. And yeah, you know, don't be that guy that on the first date talks about what you guys are going to name your kids together. Alright, the next question is by XWX Tiffany, and she asks, if you had $1 million, what would you spend it on? I would put a lot of it in the bank and just live off the interest. You know, I would never have to work unless I absolutely wanted to. I would also, you know, give money to Tina and her family, and obviously give money to my family to help them out. And I would obviously buy myself a house for me and Tina, and I guess we would just live off the interest, and Tina and I would never have to work unless we absolutely wanted to, like I said. And yeah, the next few questions are by Technical Muffin, and he asks, how old are you and Tina again? I'm 20 and she is 19, and do you feel this love is real? And of course we do, because we've been together for like 2 years, so if it wasn't real, then, you know, we probably would have broken up a long time ago. How does this love affect if it truly is real in real life? I don't really know how to answer this question. But obviously, in any relationship that you take seriously, it's going to make or break you. You know, you're going to either be really happy with the person or you're going to be really sad. And I would like to think that Tina and I are really happy together. So, all right, the next question is by MindPoolStory, and he asks, do you think MapleStory has changed your life, and was it a good change? I would say definitely yes, but not MapleStory the game itself, but more so the people that I've met over these 8 or whatever years that I've been playing. I started playing when I was 12, and I'm 20 now, so obviously I've had time to meet a lot of really great people, and you know, I owe a lot of who I am because of these people. And you know, you might find it weird that I'm saying this about people that I've never even met in real life, but these people that I've met over MapleStory have really made an impact in my life, and you know, I will forever be grateful to every single person that I've ever met on Maple, because I feel like they're a part of me, and they really made me who I am today, I think, because I did grow up with these people, so. All right, the next question is by Jaime, and he asks, how is life, and what is your favorite MapleStory moment? My life at the moment is pretty good. You know, I'm on summer break, so any time spent out of the classroom is great to me. I hate classrooms, I hate teachers. School in general just sucks. And as far as my MapleStory moment, my favorite MapleStory moment, I'm going to have to go with getting to level 200 for the first time. Because, you know, a lot of my friends were there, and a lot of you guys were there, so it was really special to me. And thank you guys who showed up for making that moment very special. Thank you. Alright, the last question is by MrCoolDude2598, and he asks, how often are you willing to help lower level people of your class? It depends on what they really need help with. I'm not really one to help people train, because it's very easy to train these days. As far as like giving them gear, I usually don't have any gear to give, but if I've done like Monster Park or something and I have some spare thief gear, then yeah, I'll definitely give it to them. And you know, if they need money or something, I've been known to help people out money wise, so I would say I'm pretty helpful. I hope. I try to be, at least. You know, I try to be nice to everyone and help out when I can. So, alright guys, that is going to wrap up episode number 9 of my Q&A series. And I hope you guys enjoyed the video as much as I did making it. And don't forget to leave your questions in the comments below so that I can get you guys questions in the next Q&A. And hope you guys have a great day. Like, favorite, subscribe, comment. Leave your questions below, and toodles.